Hi there. If you're searching for how to lose weight and keep it off, stay tuned. You're in the right spot. I'm going to go over that in just a moment. Hey there. Welcome to Lance Crone Coaching, where my mission is to eliminate confusion for weight loss and help you to get the fastest and most sustainable results. If this is your first time to the channel, welcome. Thanks so much for joining me. Be sure to subscribe to it. I've got lots of awesome information that's gonna help you out each and every week. Right now I'm doing like 2 to 3 videos a week, so stay tuned for that. Go ahead and like the video. And one thing that I love is for you to comment below during or after the video. Kind of let me know some of the things that you're struggling with, some of your thoughts. I read each and every comment, so I'll be sure to get back with you on that. So, all right, so without further ado, this is one of the things that annoys me more than anything that I hear. There's all these little anecdotes of you gotta go big or go home, you know, whenever they're talking about weight loss and fitness and all of these things. And essentially what I've noticed is all of these things are basically touting that you've got to be all or nothing if you want to get fitness results, and you've got to conform to the standard fitness methods, you know, eating every couple of hours and working out nonstop, and you just got to grin and bear it and do all of these things that honestly seem freaking terrible. And my method is so different from that. I totally believe the opposite of the go big or go home and the all or nothing mentality. The fact of the matter is that this mentality is what typically leads people to either burning out completely because they're exhausted. Maybe you've fallen prey to that. You've tried to do something where you were just really overzealous. And one of my favorite quotes is specifically that, you know, essentially, and I'm gonna paraphrase it, but essentially being overzealous and setting monstrous goals or huge goals doesn't lead to huge results. It usually leads to huge setbacks. And so that's the theology, the principles that I take with my clients. And that's why, personally, why my clients have gotten such amazing results, not only up front, but why they're able to keep such long-term results. And so my methodology is totally different. I don't believe in doing this whole, you know, go hard and you know, just grin and bear it and change everything to fit this lifestyle. And if you can't make it work, then you're just not ready. I totally disagree with that. So my methodology is way, way different. I personally believe in setting small, realistic goals that are involved with daily activities or daily actions that build consistency. So rather than us going for massive results, we're going to go for massive consistency. So we're gonna set things like making sure that we're gonna be active for 15 minutes a day, every day, no matter what. Let's build this habit so that we're going to do something that burns a decent amount of calories for just 15 minutes. If you do something more than that, great, you're ahead of the game. But what I do with my clients is I like to set good, great, and awesome goals for all of these things. So we know, obviously, you gotta be active. We know that you have to be at a deficit of calories, you know, to actually burn body fat, and so that you can decrease and actually get where you wanna go. The problem is that I can tell somebody this and put them on a crazy deficit diet and make sure that they're working out for 45 minutes a day and doing this stuff. And if it feels like it's too much too soon, you might get results early on, but you're not gonna be able to feel like this is something you can keep up indefinitely. To me, that's not success. That's ultimately failure, because if you're not able to do something that conforms to your lifestyle and helps you to moderately make tweaks, etc., you're wasting your time. And personally, I'm misleading you and leading you down the wrong path. So my method here specifically isn't going to be focusing on those big, huge goals like that. We wanna look for consistency. So what I do for the activity part of things is I like to have my clients do good, great, and awesome goals to where good might be 15 minutes a day of activity. Now, yes, I want them to do my workouts, etc., because those are high intensity interval training workouts. They work really well. I put a lot of effort into those to make sure that they burn the maximum amount of fat in the shortest amount of time, so that, you know, again, all of my clients are busy moms who are on the go, who have limited time, and I take that very seriously. So that's the first thing. The second is to make sure that you have So you have your good, great, and awesome goal. Your great goal might be 20 minutes a day. Your awesome goal might be 25 or 30 minutes a day. So by doing this, rather than focusing on getting these 45-minute workouts 2 to 3 times a week that really doesn't build a habit, we focus on just being consistent by being active 15 minutes a day. Once we have that mastered, we start incrementing it upwards so that we do 20 minutes a day, then 25, etc. I never have my clients go more than 30 minutes a day for workouts. It's not necessary. It's a waste of time. It's not to say that if you already do that and you enjoy it and you're consistent that you're doing something wrong. It's just that for my clients, it doesn't make sense long term to do that. So my notion here again is to focus on doing the small consistent things, build up that consistency so that you can not only trust and see that you're doing things regularly and consistently, which is gonna build up your faith and your ability to do this stuff. You're also gonna start noticing some results that those results actually are going to reinforce what you're doing, which all of a sudden now motivates and encourages you organically to take it to the next level. So rather than me going, you know, it's time for you to go to 20 or 25 or 30 minutes, or you gotta go hard and you gotta do all the stuff that you hear people say, the natural progression, whenever you're being consistent in these small things, what I call small wins, I say that small wins lead to big victories. This here is what leads you into scaling naturally and progressing up to the next level. Likewise with nutrition. I can push doing, you know, the leanest and stoutest nutrition plan, and the fact of the matter is it might work to get you some results, but if you dread it and feel like you can't go out, you can't enjoy social events, you gotta kiss goodbye going to restaurants and eating out, and all of these things for a busy mom are pretty much unrealistic for most people. So for me, again, I say that we start small, we start eliminating some things that are maybe immediate no-goes that don't fit, but really what I do is work on small things so that we start pushing, you know, just simply tracking what you're eating so that we're at least aware. So being aware sometimes just all of a sudden shows you like, whoa, this is more calories than what I thought it was. Now there's a little bit of accountability. Step two, the next progression, is to know exactly how many calories we should be trying to burn in a given day or consume in a given day to actually lose weight. So knowing those two things in and of itself are going to at least guide us in the right direction. Once we start seeing some results and knowing where we're at organically, again, you begin to progress in such a way that you decide that, okay, I'm ready to take it to the next level, but it's a small level. So we're building consistency. We're not doing this all or nothing, go big or go home theology. So one of the other ways that I like to do this small goals, small victories, or small wins leading to big victories is specifically, whenever people want to start coaching with me or working with me in my weight loss programs, what I like to do is to push them into doing one of my small programs. We want to just kind of get their feet wet. This helps, again, to show like, okay, cool, I can make it through this. It's just 7 days. So one of the things that I do is I have my seven-day flat belly formula course. It's free. I'll put the link below. Click on that. It's going to show you just a little bit. It's going to give some awesome workouts, and it's going to get your feet wet for 7 days without you feeling like you're committing to the next 6 months. So it goes through helping things with goal setting and all of those sort of things. But all we're doing is building up this consistent, these little habits that lead to results, which lead to bigger and better, stronger habits, which lead to better and bigger results. So the main thing to focus on here is to make sure that whenever you're setting goals, that you're setting goals that are based on consistency and to be focused on the process more than the result. So there's a few different ways that we can do this here, but one of the main things is to, again, break things down into daily goals or daily activities, which lead to your 30-day goal. If you're focused on a 6-month goal and then you're trying to lose all of this weight in a certain amount of time, instead of committing yourself to the activity, this is where you have burnout, this is where you get overwhelmed, and then eventually what happens is you feel so deprived or feel like you're overworking. and it doesn't fit into your lifestyle, so you end up giving it up. So I implore you to absolutely focus on the small goals. And again, one of the best ways to do this here, if you're not sure where to start, click the link below, get into my 7-day course, my 7-day flat belly course. It's totally free, and it's a perfect way to start very bite-sized to get some results, to show you some quick wins, get your feet wet, and then to be ready for the next thing. And the next thing after that you can do, I've got an awesome 4-week flat belly challenge. I do one of those a month. They fill up really quickly, but it's an amazing way to, again, not commit to something long-term, but to get you building up habits that actually fit into your lifestyle instead of making your lifestyle fit into this rigid program. So hope this helps. Hope this is something that kind of sheds a little bit of light that if you're focusing on this all or nothing theology, that you've got to jump in with both feet into fitness and to weight loss, and you've got to meal prep and spend hours at the gym and give up good tasting foods and not have wine and social events and all this stuff, you're doing it wrong. You're not going to get where you want to go, or you're going to burn out before you ever get there or you're able to keep this up. So again, hopefully this helps you. If it did, please hit the like button below. Let me know what your comments are, your thoughts. So thanks again. Be sure to subscribe and click the like button, and stay tuned for my next video. Thanks.